talked very, very briefly at the AG chambers before he left in January, and I trusted that the other limb of your question. When I issue referees, I don't go to them or even alert them that they may expect A, B, C, and D, or coach them. That is how open I am. I leave it entirely to them to give any information that you may ask, etc., etc. If you haven't, I am available now, today and tomorrow. I could carry those things to them. Dr. Akunga Momai, I cannot commit myself on that. Parklands is a difficult area, I may not be able to see him. As to whether you'd be willing to do a commentary on myself, I cannot answer that. He taught me about 15 years ago, 205, 206. This is 1610, this is 20, 13 years ago in my LLM program at the University of Nairobi. I'm not even sure whether you wanted to do that. But teachers are the people we look for as referees in academics. So he asked that, but I cannot promise you that I'll be able to get him. I'm not sure whether Professor Bodeni has done that. He's available. I can get him. So if you wanted me to pass these letters of inquiry to them, I would do that. As to answers, I will not bind myself on that, because what the best I would do is pass the letter and leave it to them. And
Thank you, Judge. We were just concerned whether these people know you, because they did not respond, but you've already responded to
them.
They
know me very, very well.
Thank you. Next question concerns the wealth declaration.
Yes.
Before I can address that, maybe I would want to hear from you, Judge. Why do you think we require you to periodically file wealth declarations, and even at the time of filing your application?
The rationale behind wealth declarations was the issues on integrity, the ESCC, and particularly you may call it the right corruption. That document will be able to tell you that Judge Marete, before he came to the judiciary, owned bra, 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 bra. After the judiciary, A, B, C. And then you would have to make your own conclusions. You are sharp and good. Those who manage that are supposed to be expert. Even the best of idiots or fools would be able to look at that and see, now this doesn't make sense. Judge Marete owns some property which is half a billion. I also would find it difficult to imagine that. So that is the essence of all declarations.
Thank you.
We do them.
It gives us an avenue to be able to probe and maybe audit.
True.
Thank you.
Yes.
I looked at your wealth declarations. You are required to submit the last three, and you did.
Yes.
But some concerns were raised. Or I have some concerns,
yes,
concerning the declarations that you filled,
yes,
that give rise to my questions.
Please.
Judge, you earn a salary.
Yes.
That is income.
Yes.
In the three declarations that you filed,
yes,
you've indicated your income as N stroke A. What does that mean?
Not applicable.
Why is that?
My answer to that is that in my own imagination, my cleverness or lack of it, is that when you're asking for income, you're asking for extra, not my pay. Because I imagine that you know my pay, everybody knows my pay, it's public knowledge. So it's extra income. Do I do business? Do I farm and sell produce? etc. That is why I answered it that way. If I thought differently, or if I had your idea of what income means, the answer would be very clear.
But you realize that you started off from the premise that that would help us do some sort of audit, so that we're able to look at, you gave the example that if someone said you owned a property worth 500 billion, would question, on what basis would you question that if we do not know what your income is?
You know, declaration, the concept and the law came in 2003 after the NARC revolution in 2002. We have dealt with it from our TSE days, blah, blah, up to where we are. And all this time, my conception of the income was anything apart from salary. That's
okay,
where
Judge.
I went wrong. In the future, I am learning, and even on that one, if you wanted a statement on my income in those years, salary available.
Great. Then you can supply us with that before this process is over.
My pay slips, I'm scattered all over. Some of my service in Eldoret, some of my service in Nyeri, I have not moved from Eldoret. That may be a tall order unless I ask my employer to give me extra details. If that, and I cannot work on anything which I am not in control.
Okay, let me leave that to you. Another concern I had about your wealth declaration is that.
Am I allowed to ask a question? Good.
Yes, sir.
Your Honor,
because she has left it to me. Does that mean that I would have to do it, or is left open? Because I can't see myself being able to go and go walk through Eldoret, get the payslips, go to, and those are old ones. Those are many years ago. It may not be practical before you clear the exercise. But I can promise you that, say, the next, how many months? We are in, before the close of the vacation, in the summer vacation. In September, I'll be able to give you that. If you require it, then please tell me so that I can look for them.
Commissioner, or rather, maybe you can explain how many. I think it's the last one that you need, not all of them, or the latest.
Okay, Judge, the advertisement required you to supply the last three. You supplied. You supplied for 2016, 2018, and 2020, and all of them had that anomaly. They did not have.
It has been permanent from two or three.
Yes. And what I wanted to say is that the advertisement was there, and it is for you to comply. That's why I said we are leaving it to you. If you are talking about September, I do not believe that this commission will put this whole exercise off until September, when you can avail your wealth declarations. So I still maintain I leave it to you, or we leave it to you, to see if you can supply with whatever necessary information that we may need before determination is made. On the next issue, the next
Judge, you can finish what you are saying, Your Honor.
Yes, I was moving on to the next issue that I have with your wealth declaration, if you can permit me. Again, in the description of assets, where you're supposed to indicate the assets that you have, I noticed that you did not disclose your bank accounts. I do believe you have bank accounts.
Yes.
Or at least even a bank account.
Yes.
You did not disclose that.
Mm-hmm.
I also noted that you did not file a separate statement for your spouse, as is required in the guidelines on that form. And another crucial one that I noticed is that in the wealth declaration, the last wealth declaration that you filed in 2020,
yes,
you had acquired a new property,
yes,
somewhere in Ngong,
yes,
worth 30 million.
That is not a new property. Good. Please ask your question and finish so that I can answer.
Yes, the challenge I'm having, again, on the same premise that we had agreed on earlier, that these declarations help us to make an assessment and do some kind of audit. You do not have a commensurate loan, because I would imagine probably it's a loan or a mortgage that you've taken worth that amount of money. Your income has not been indicated.
Yes.
This property worth 30 million does not appear in your wealth declaration of 2016 and 2018.
Yes.
So I presumed it was acquired between 2018 and 2020.
Yes, that property worth 20 million is
30 million.
My home in Ongata Rongai. I entered that property on the 1st of September 1996. It was 30 million even before I got to the TSC, So 30 million even before I go to the judiciary. So if it is not appearing on my other wealth declaration forms, it is an error. It would, and I believe I should have, and I have always wanted to, it is my prime property. In my own imagination, I always give it as a part of my wealth. And if I have not done it on any of the other of the others, that is an error. I can correct that by in a write-up or any other by any other means. That is a property I've owned almost virtually all my life. 1996 and today is almost 30 years, or well over 25 years.
Okay, thank you, Judge. I just want also to bring it to your attention that we, in the process of vetting, doing background checks, we received a complaint from one Eddie Kiprono Koech. We received your response to it, and I do not have questions to that. I will leave it for the consideration of the commission. Thank you, Judge, and I wish you well.
Chair.
Yes, Your Honor.
I have issues with the commissioner. She has raised an issue on her bank statements. She has raised an issue on my wife's income, and lastly on the complaint. There's something I did not get, and when I get all this, my question will be: does the commission expect a response on this? I have noted bank statements. I've noted my wife's income, and I've not answered it. I could answer that, be allowed to answer that, or be enabled to answer that. The complaint is done itself, I answered. So what was the other issue?
Judge, if you have an explanation, please feel free to give it, an explanation as to why you did not file a separate statement as required for your spouse, and any other issue that I have raised, please feel free to give that explanation.
So there are three issues: the issue of my 30,000 property,
that 30 million property,
the issue of bank statements, and the issue of my wife. Do I answer the one for my wife and then have a balance of the two?
Please answer whichever you want to answer.
Yes, my wife is a retiree. She retired three years ago. She is not doing anything. She's around 63 or so years. She's just at home and resting. She takes a pension from the judiciary, 33,000 shillings, and eats it. Number two, misconception or wrong interpretation. All my life, from 2003, and that is why these things are bringing issues to me, I construed wealth declaration to be personal, and the issue of salary, the issue of bank account, the issue of my wife never arose to me. I'm learning now, and in the future I'll interrogate that and comply. So if that answer doesn't satisfy you insofar as my wife's declarations, when she was in the public service, she would do hers, I would do mine. That was 3 years ago. She is not now. She's a pensioner. She takes her 33,000 shillings every month. Eats it or throws it away. That is not a matter which would really concern me so badly. But if you require me to do a write-up to that extent, I'm available.
Judge, this is coming out of the vetting process, and this process continues until the commission makes a decision and nominates one of the 10 candidates. I just thought I should bring that to your attention. And what you are required to file under the Form 2B is a separate statement of your wife's income, assets, and liabilities. She may have retired 38 years ago, after serving for 38 years, but she may be having some assets. She has an income in the form of a pension. She may be having liabilities. That is what you are required to file. Thank you, Judge.
Thank you. We shall comply.
Thank you, Judge. And just to emphasize what Commissioner already has said, that we still have some time to submit those documents, because we can still consider them until we make a nomination.
Thank you.
Thank you. So, Honorable Commissioners and your Honor, we have come to the end of this interview. And Judge, thank you very much for coming, and also for your answers and the discussion that has happened. Thank you for being very patient with the commissioners. I would like to give you a chance, Your Honor, to tell us anything that you would want to tell us, or ask any question at this point.
Thank you, good chair of the commission. I must thank you so much for firstly affording me an opportunity to engage you on this auspicious occasion of the selection of the Chief Justice of the 15th Chief Justice of the Republic of Kenya. It is such a honor. Even allowing me to be here is a privilege. I appreciate and thank you so much. I thank you for the openness. I thank the people of Kenya for opening it up. We had days when this would not have happened. Two, you remember the INFJ, the extraordinary leader? Here he is, a leader without any followers, a leader without office or portfolio. If you wish to do Kenya a favor, and a big one for that matter, here we are. We offer ourselves to demonstrate to Kenya that these things are doable. And we can do them in style and simplicity. I am simple. I am straightforward, I am reliable, I am very, very focused and outrightly extraordinary and organized. If this is not the person you are looking for, we can debate that. But in me, you have that and extras. Thank you so much. When you sit and make your final conclusion, remember that messages come in the air. And to me, Kenya has spoken, and there we are. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Your Honor. We have heard, the commissioners have heard what you have said about your personality description. Did you call it INFJ?
FJ. Google B Miles MBTI. Myers Briggs type indicator. You learn the whole science of a personality type.
Thank you, Judge.
MBTI.
We have heard, and we wish you all the best. And once again, thank you very much for availing yourself for this interview.
Thank you. And some water, or do you have water?